Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to the BioWay channel. We will continue our discussion of classification of carbohydrate, and in this video we will see about the polysaccharides. What do you mean by polysaccharides? They are sugar polymers having more than 20 monosaccharide units in them. So polysaccharides are divided into homopolysaccharide and heteropolysaccharide. Homopolysaccharides are having single monosaccharide unit linked with the glycosidic bond, while in case of heteropolysaccharide, there are two or more number of monosaccharide unit linked together by the glycosidic bond. Among homopolysaccharides, there are unbranched homopolysaccharide like cellulose, while there are branched homopolysaccharide. One example is starch or glycogen. In terms of heteropolysaccharide, in case of unbranched, there is an example of peptidoglycan, and in case of branched heteropolysaccharide, there is an example of heparin. Now coming to the homopolysaccharide, let us go to the example that we use regularly in our diet, and this may be your favorite food also, popcorns. Can you tell me the polysaccharide present in this? Yes, you may have guessed it. It is nothing but the polysaccharide called as starch. So from the popcorn, we get a very important dietary source of energy, that is the polysaccharide called as starch. Starch is made up of two important polymers. One is amylose, which is nothing but the linear chain of glucose units bound together with the help of glycosidic bond, that is alpha-1,4 glycosidic bond. And the second polymer in starch is called as amylopectin, which is a branch polymer of glucose unit in which the branch point is linked with the alpha-1,6 glycosidic bond. You can see how amylose and amylopectin, the two important components of a starch, they are coming together to form a very large polysaccharide. We call it starch. Then coming to the next polysaccharide, which is present in many animals including us, this is giving us the energy when we are fasting, that is we haven't had any food. Like in case of morning walk, this gives you the energy, and the molecule is called as the very important polysaccharide glycogen. Now glycogen is consisting of a polymer of alpha-1,4 linked subunit of glucose, and also one more component kind of amylopectin that is having glucose unit alpha-1,6 linked. And this is having a difference with respect to starch, that it is more extensively branched than the starch. Then coming to the next example of polysaccharide, let us go to the jungle. What we are observing is the very important polysaccharide that we find in the nature. Yes, I am talking about all the trees. They are having a very important polysaccharide called as cellulose. Now cellulose, it is a linear polymer and it is made up of glucose units linked with beta-1,4 glycosidic bond. Now we will come to the heteropolysaccharide. Heteropolysaccharide consists of more than two types of monosaccharide unit linked with a glycosidic bond. So we are taking example over here is of heteropolysaccharide present in the bacterial cell wall, and the polysaccharide present in this bacteria is called as peptidoglycan. Peptidoglycan, which consists of N-acetyl glucosamine and N-acetyl muramic acid linked with a glycosidic bond, and they are also having peptide bridge in between them, and in this way they form a very important peptidoglycan heteropolysaccharide which is present in the bacterial cell wall. So in this way we have studied about the polysaccharide. If you have liked this particular video, then kindly like, share, comment and subscribe. Bye-bye.
Subscribe to my YouTube channel, The BioWay on YouTube, and press the bell icon so that you will never miss another update from my channel. Thank you.